and Graves will be the first choice taken away. That has
very carries.
And the Kog'Maw.
Yeah, Graves, no surprise there. H2K banned Lulu in the last game, even though that's not too much of a takeaway. It is, I guess, I mean, if you run this composition where you want to snipe the back line and like one shot, one target, I guess taking away Lulu does make a lot of sense in that way, but it's going to be a support Lulu anyway for SK. That's what we've seen all split long.
And lately they've been mixing it up anyway, so that's the question. Do they go for it again? This time they ban the Graves and the Caitlyn. They've definitely shown they're not afraid of the Lucian. And I don't think, based on the performance last time, it really wasn't much of an issue for H2K at all.
Oh, that's very true. The lane swap early, then coming
Jinx
back.
Ban.
So still the two AD carry bans. Gragas was there, the other one that SK Gaming has been banning in every single game so far.
Ah.
Changes that one up to a Zed and says, okay, you know what? We almost rather have you play Gragas with no hyper carries to protect than the Sejuani, but I think Lulu can still go for it if he wants it here. If they want to run the same kind of composition,
of course,
with Forgiven on Lucian, well, Sejuani is open for you. Janna is open as a first pick for Kasing, which prevents the likes of a Shyvana from ever engaging onto a fight. He did stop Freddy a few times, so Freddy also just wasn't never there to fight really on this Shyvana here. He didn't manage to do a whole lot. So by taking that Janna again, they would deny any possible engage from Freddy.
Yeah, I think it makes a lot of sense to try and go for something like that. We'll see what they do eventually lock in. They still have the possibility to go for the Rumble Sejuani combo if it doesn't get picked away. Gragas, though, is the priority.
Okay.
And that's
Gragas
what they take.
Value Gragas over Janna and then a Sejuani next rotation. It is a champion Sven plays. I don't think that's worth it for H2K. If I'm playing against SK Gaming, I don't mind Svenskam playing Gragas. That would make my early game a whole lot easier against him. And at the same time, SK rarely runs these compositions, which is so heavily focused on just kiting, kiting, kiting. They like to be the one who can make the aggressive plays, who can run the 1-3-1 setup. So a little bit surprised about this one for H2K. Not that Lulex is not a good Gragas player, he's a fantastic one. He picked it all 5 games against Fnatic.
But is it really worth the first pick? That's the question.
I would have just
the Janna for this.
Because
the
Sejuani is open, then I would have gone Janna first pick. I know SK Gaming will pick it if it's open, and then I would just go for Sejuani next rotation.
Yeah, and then they could have grabbed the Rumble on top of it regardless, or if they'd waited to see what the top lane pick was. As it stands, SK Gaming let the clock tick down. They take the Lucian, they take the Janna. And let's see what H2K decide to grab on their next go around.
No real surprise for SK Gaming in their picks. Still has the Shyvana if they want it for top lane. Still has the last pick as well for mid lane, which is what they've been using so far. Vladimir and Orianna, Shucks called it out. Do have to agree, we haven't seen a whole lot from these two picks. Orianna missed, I think, nearly every single Shockwave.
Yeah.
So
the Vlad was definitely a better choice, at least a more effective choice, but it still wasn't enough to...
It made it hard to play with the comp from SK Gaming, and it meant they didn't have any clear-cut power spikes for themselves, and because they never could really engage, the Vladimir could never really get in there. Janna could always also knock her away. Sivir, obviously, with 280 carry bans, well, Janna is going to keep going back to the champion he's been playing all split long, which does work for H2K if they want this diving composition as well.
Yeah, and they have a Thresh now too, so that lends
it's a lot
some
more
interesting
kite,
possibilities.
It's a lot more kite with the Gragas as well.
Mm-hmm.
What he can do, what Gragas does really well, is he can zone out like one target with his ulti. He knocks one target back to you, knocks the rest away. But it's a lot harder to do compared to Sejuani with the ulti, stunning a few targets. Thresh as well can be used a lot more as disengage. If you want pure engage, you would have gone for like an Annie here focusing instead in this situation. So H2K is mixing it up quite a bit, and Freddy decided to say, okay, enough is enough with the Shyvana.
Yeah, they're going to go ahead and take the tree. Also, Svenskeren will be back on Lee Sin. Should be happy about that one. This could be a very early snowballing composition if SK can get the ball rolling and dominate the lanes.
Yeah. We have the early game to Lee Sin.
Maokai's a little bit different, but I mean, it's just such a strong pick in general.
You got a safe passive top laner, but you got a very, very strong 2v2 lane bottom lane. So H2K most likely looking to swap again like they did in the last game and then try and deny Freddy some farm.
They will give up a dragon, Maokai, most likely, if they do it again, though. So we could be in for another
one of those early
games.
Yeah, they can play different here and use their Thresh on the bottom side of the map to deny that first dragon from SK, or at least make it a lot harder. for them if it's gonna be casted in mid.
Oh,
then normally
boy.
normally we would expect Odo Omniden to go for the likes of a Sion up top lane.
Oh, and he does.
There it is.
You called it Officio, but a blind pick casted in mid for Ryu. Laying it all on the table.
Well, what
game four?
I mean, what picks do we have from SK that could do really well completely shutting down the Kassadin? Zed would have been a go-to one, but he's been banned away here. And mainly what we see then is AP assassins like LeBlanc,
like Ahri,
which Kassadin can farm very well against. He's not going to kill them in the laning phase, but he can sit and go even in farm when you start stacking up these potions as well. So in that case, as a blind pick, it's not that risky from H2K to have some decent wave there in terms of Gragas, Sivir, even the Sion can add in something there in that department.
Question is though, do you think that they focus this on SK Gaming side? They have a Lee Sin who can
Maybe.
Make a lot of plays early
and
on.
And can SK surprise something here in the mid lane? Is there something that H2K were not expecting? Or are we going to go
with the Orianna?
Very standard AP from them. And this Orianna was not good in game two from SK Gaming. Now, you can put it on the Maokai, you can put it on the Lee Sin, and you can almost guarantee a Shockwave to connect if they want to, but it's going to be hard for him. While you will push down the castle into his tower, you don't really have a whole lot of kill threat on him in that mid lane, so Ryu should be okay in terms of farming. Svenskan will get time, though, to invade in on this Lee Sin. He will have his mid laner backing him up very easily and force the castle to sit on the tower. Not that Orianna wants to roam, but you force the castle to sit and farm. Lee Sin can then invade into the jungle of H2K and use that to kind of roam between the lanes, get a bit of the deep wards in and try and set up an early snowball for SK. Because we know they're going to do well in the bottom lane 2v2. If they do the same setup as before, once they swap to standard lanes after the lane swap from H2K, which we're expecting once again, because also Sion is doing so well in 1v2s, well then we know that it's going to have the wards on the bottom side of the map from SK, allow for Given to push in that tower, rotate mid lane against the no wave that casted in, which is the risk from H2K here. And then you take down two out of turrets very easily with your AD carry. That's what SK Gaming can do here. They should be able to control that early game really well and go back to more of a style we know from them where they can snowball from strong lanes.
Exactly. It'll be up to H2K to see if they get those lanes that they want though. But for now, you guys tell us what you think. We're still a match point here. It is game number four. Do H2K have the momentum to take it all the way to five? Well, you let us know. Tweet at LL Esports. Hashtags, of course, R-H2K win or SK win. And we'll find out where this one's going in just a sec. Here we are on the Rift.
Why we said the Kassadin in terms of what could SK pick against it wasn't that risky to blind pick. It's more about the play style of SK. You know they're going to look for these early towers. Kassadin will not offer any wave there, as we just talked about. That's going to be the risk for Ryu. They want to send him out of that mid lane once the bottom tower goes down and they know the swap with Forgiven and then Reddit goes to mid. They want to have Jan and Kha'Zix sitting there to kind of try and counter it and just push it back with the Sivir while Ryu can try and get some farm down the bottom lane. But that's going to be later in the game. If they do go for standard lanes, I want to see Lulix try and pay a lot of attention on this bottom side.
This is some confidence in the bottom lane of H2K if they think that they can go toe-to-toe with
Sivir.
Forgiven on the Lucian.
Sivir Thresh is not a bad lane.
No, it's definitely not. But it's still very, very daunting. And we heard in the video earlier that you got to give a lot of respect to Forgiven for what he's able to accomplish. But clearly they're not fearing the Lucian anymore.
At least not in the start. Or maybe they just don't want SK to get an early tower and end the laning phase very quickly to stop the Kassadin from farming. If you do lane swap and you try and slow it down, it should buy a bit more time for Ryu. Or sorry, if you do take standard lanes and you just play it safe, that should buy more time for Ryu to farm up in this mid lane. And if you do end up losing the 2v2 lane, you can try and at least use Yharnam as a defensive tool and hold off Forgiven around the mid lane later. Because the thing H2K likes to do as well is if they're losing 2v2, once they have a BF sword on Yharnam, they like to take him out of that lane and try and trade a tower that's going to die anyway in the bottom lane and just put him like top lane. Push that one in with the Sivir with the BF sword and try and trade towers. It's a thing they've done in the past. Could see it happening again, depending on how this lane goes for them. Both teams obviously starting with a jungle camp. Except for Freddy, I think he just did the small Raptors. Yeah, he did. I just saw his CS numbers.
Everyone starts the jungle with the mid lane, really. So the lanes are left unattended for just a moment. Odoami goes ahead and does the Wolf camp. Typical top, Sion start. Be teleporting up in just a moment.
Wanting the Lumberjack skin, playing against the Maokai.
Hopefully, he'll be able to chop down the tree. That's what he's thinking.
I really want to see the bottom lane here, how they're trading early on. They're both trying to race for level 2. Obviously, good little trade from H2K at first. Nice response, though, from Forgiven and Enredo. We didn't get to see how many minions has gone down already, but there's the level 2 for Kasing and Yanen.
They've got it.
Matched by SK, though, and suddenly we're back to even.
Wasn't much of a timing window, but it is so, so difficult to trade against SK, especially when you've got Forgiven on a champion like Lucian, who's passive, that double tap ability, he can get twice the harass.
So they does have a good early start, though, and good early laning phase to push it in. Potion was used from Forgiven. You of course have the Relic Shield as well, providing some HP from the Thresh onto Yanen here, and they got that first push. Can they connect a hook from Kasing? That's how they want to start it. Otherwise, as you see that what they're doing now is making it very hard for Forgiven to pick trades because he has to focus his CSing on getting the last hits on the tower. So by H2K just constantly pushing down the wave, it's very easy to predict what SK is going to do in the lane.
They do have that going for them right now. Svenskeren finds Lulex and won't hit the Sonic Wave as both junglers with their double buffs start these things off. Oduwamne gets a bit of damage notched onto the Tree of Freddy, who's taking a lot of damage from the minions after the fact, actually. Yeah. Everything else trading pretty even. Ryu's been pushed in by the Orianna Fox. Well, and Svenskeren now following forward on the Lulex, but he shouldn't have enough damage to finish him.
So this is exactly what we talked about beforehand, how Orianna's going to push in the Kassadin in. While she won't follow in the jungle, she's going to keep him stuck on the tower, opening up for Svenskeren to invade in. Gragas, once he gets level 6, does fine against the Lee Sin, but early on, he can struggle just a little bit. He's still a very safe jungler. And while Sven is a fantastic Lee Sin player, it is hard for him to completely punish Lulex. It's going to be more about just applying pressure and maybe forcing back the bottom lane from pushing if Sven can walk down behind him, and so on.
Well, and speaking of pressure, it's definitely on him to make those plays early. This is where Lee Sin likes to shine, getting his team to a solid mid-game and contributing during that. The later the game goes, the usefulness will eventually fall off, but they've got some other scaling there to do for them if it gets to that point in the game. We'll see what happens.
I don't really feel like they can match H2K in that way. Kassadin in late game with this Athene build is so, so strong as long as he gets rolling in the teamfights. He's very, very weak, and the build is very, very weak if you fall behind because you have to secure that kill on assist in the fight. And you have to jump in with your ulti to deal damage. So if you are behind, you just end up jumping in, not having enough damage, and just die, basically. So obviously, in that sense, Ryu is going to have a good start on the Kassadin. But if you look at overall scaling, the double Cinderhulk is so, so good late game, where Lee Sin, as you said, will fall off really, really hard compared to a Gragas jungle. And that's going to be a big deal for H2K going late.
That certainly will. Back in the mid lane, very even trades here. Ryu sustaining up through the use of flasks and biscuits to boot. While in the bottom side, you can see Yarn and Kasing pushing back, Forgiven and Enraided. It's actually been fairly even on farm in that case too. Really, really even start to this game across the board.
Huh,
and the laning just continues.
I've seen the skirmishes Saber a few times on Gragas in Europe. Often, if you are against an early aggressive jungler, like Svenskeren on a Lee Sin, you build it and simply try and be a bit stronger in the one-on-ones, and then late game, you use it to obviously tank up damage from the likes of a Lucian. You just smite him, get the 20% damage reduction. So that's what Lulex is aiming for here on the Gragas. Setting up a gank around the bottom lane.
Spotted by the ward, though.
Pretty sure they saw him, and the ward is on him.
Shouldn't be any problem, man. Oop, that hook is not going to quite hit Kasing. For all he's been trying the flay wheel, though. Given dodges out after that. Nice trade though from H2K's bot lane. As Svenskeren goes on an invade trek, finds himself a Gromp in the jungle of H2K.
And while we talked a bit about lane swap before, and I really like how H2K decided to do standard lanes. It slows down the early game in that sense for Ryu to farm.
Mm-hmm.
Sivir can do fine, just push the lane over and over, and you trade fine against the Lucian. So it's a good start for H2K with their comp. Sven obviously is still trying to invade in and deny farm from Lulex, which he's done a decent job of. No gank's been pulled off yet. And if you look at the lanes, I mean, he can try and gank the bottom lane. That's going to be pretty much the only one, because top lane has been pushing in against Oduwamne over and over. Mid lane we know is going to push in against the Kassadin. So bottom lane is where the focus should be, but there's no real CC to set up a gank for him. So as long as there's decent early wards from Kasing.
Oh, Ryu checks in. Yeah, but Lulex is there. Just like that, the gank and the counter gank starts. Lex just in time, and Ryu trusting that was going to happen exactly as they needed. They burned two summoners on Fox.
Really want to push it in again from H2K. Nice little trade at least. Game left flash away. Svenskin was setting up for some shenanigans. Didn't really manage to pull it off. Because there's basically there for Comic Gang.
Oh, Sven's coming in. Oh, he kicks out Ryu actually. But he's got the Rift Walk and he dodges. Puts on his walking shoes. Lulex moves away. Don't get punished for the clearing of the pink ward.
With this counter jungling here from Sven, he's gotten a small level advantage over Lulex. Got level 6 first. Went for the play. Didn't manage to get any summoners. And now there's a Sion.
Here comes the Sion. He'll get stopped by a wall.
It's a wall. They can go collapse on Sven here, though. He's trying to sneak in and get a blue buff. H2K should not allow this one. There's no mana in the mid lane.
Not anymore, yeah. He has to back away. Freddy's here too, though.
No, they're
not going to stop this. It's going to go over to Ryu. So, TP teleport down to the bottom lane, though, because Singh is going to be in some trouble as the Twisted Advance is going to go on to him. The hook on it forgiven, but they don't want to take a 2v3, because Singh could go down here, and he does. That's going to be first blood. Taken by Forgiven.
So no TP for Moto Omni. They also saw him move down to secure that blue buff. Freddy knowing he could make a play then. We talked about how this was the lane you could gank for SK Gaming, and they do get a kill for it. We'll be able to go back as well, Forgiven, but obviously the top tower makes a bit of a beating for it.
Yeah, that's the trade that they take. No more teleport after Freddy uses his. The wave won't be enough to help Moto Omni clear this one out. Sion not exactly known for his high damage. The axe is going to be big, though. So SK get on the board. They've got the first kill of the game, but the gold is still very much even in this one. And H2K, as you mentioned, they're happy to draw this out. We talked about the lack of jungle pressure in the lanes, even though there was a bit of action in the mid, and then, of course, a teleport down top by Freddy.
Yeah.
The less jungle pressure, better for H2K, I feel.
As I said with the Gragas, I do like him at level 6, though, here, so I don't feel like that's too big of a problem. Kasing, though, it's been caught out.
Yeah, but Ryu's here too. And he's got a lot of damage at his back end. Raiden's gonna try to push him back. Oh no, the kick. Ryu, will he live through this one? He burns his flash. In comes Lulex. Not enough damage from the Janna. They trade out them. Oh, the Howling Gale isn't enough either. But very, very close. Lulex instead will go down. And Svenskeren stays alive for another day. The tag team from H2K sees Lulex taken out.
This was set up though by Kasing roaming alone as a support here, and a good ping ward for SK to start the pick here with SK Gaming, or with Svenskeren, sorry, on the Lee Sin and N-rated roaming up from the bottom side. That's gonna force a mid lane tower a lot earlier. Cassidy not able to defend it. So it doesn't go down now. Well, it will.
Well, soon enough,
it's a matter of time.
They did a lot of damage
onto
it.
Well, next time they do decide to go mid, they want to get that dragon instead while they still have the numbers advantage for them. Just a very nice ping ward in the river to create that setup.
And Fox zoning as well with the command attack. So first dragon of the game picked up by SK Gaming on top of the other kill they'd already secured near to taking the tower. They put themselves in a favorable position. 10.5 into this game. Back to the game.
Why do we never sit like that, Pyro? Like in the old days.
Yeah, we really should.
Old days, I've known you for like 3 months.
I know, that's old days are like 2 months ago.
Basically. So, early game looking great for SK. Mid lane tower will go down very easily. Then they can focus on the bottom side. You go into deep ward behind it, you suddenly force Yannin to be very, very scared every time he tries to clear out the waves, and then you will always get a bit of damage on him. You will slowly chip it away. Another pick around this pink ward here.
They find Lulex, the shockwave is on him too, and another one. Yes, indeed. And a teleport canceled by Oda Wamnik, because Singh now won't make it out alive as he gets kicked right back in, and Fox takes him out.
That one pink ward has given SK Gaming so many kills. It's given them the mid tower now. It's going to give them the dragon from before. H2K keep trying to walk in and clear it out, or at least walk around it, and Sven is just sitting there waiting.
Constantly. So,
that's really paid off. Really paid off using that Lee Sin so well. The champion that got banned against Unicorns of Love because he was destroying people. He had like a 10-0 game. Let's see what happens top. Oda Wamnik is taking a lot of damage on the tower here.
Yeah, he is, but Ryu now coming in to try and clean it up. Oda Wamnik bailing it. No, they don't have enough, and Ignite was used. Heavy investment by H2K. It doesn't get him anything. It might get the tower. Nope. Fox is going to go ahead and knock over the one in the middle, or the minions will do it.
No damage from the Kassadin yet. It's still very slow scaling. You need the Rod of Ages. You need to get the Athenes.
Could be a late Rod of Ages, too, at this rate.
you want the team fights. Only the Catalyst is not going to do anything for Ryu.
Oh, and
now
that's not either.
Down as well. I mean, that play was very unnecessary for him to try and force. But it almost feels like H2K is saying, we are falling so far behind. If we don't try a risky play, we will maybe never even get to a point where we can fight.
Flash forced by Lulex onto Fox. The tower's going to go down to the bottom. But you're right. SK have gotten themselves to a comfortable position, and H2K just seem to be playing not optimally. They've given up so much here just by trying to force the issue, and they have the scaling on their side.
And it's fun to see how SK Gaming, with Forgiven being shot down in the last game, has removed the early focus away from him. This is one of the first times I've seen N-Rated roam around during the early game on a support, not sitting and babysitting Forgiven, but instead join Svenska and look for kills around the mid lane, and it's paid off for SK. Yes, they lost the bottom lane tower, but you gain so much in the middle of the map instead that it's definitely worth it for them. And I like the adaptation, saying, you know what, you're playing Lucian, you got shut down last game, you're gonna be a little bit on your own. We focus around our Orianna, and of course with the Lee Sin early game to make the plays. And now he is one of the roams bottom lane. We talked about this. Once the mid tower is gone, it opens up for Svenskan to roam through the jungle and make it so hard for H2K to sit in this bottom lane, because you always have that fear of four men just showing up, killing you under your own tower.
Very possible with SK's playstyle, the way they are in this game right now, a deep pink ward placed down. SK have definitely been investing more in the vision this series so far. Yharnam now gets hit up by Svenskeren, kicked back. On the hunt is popped. He's going to use heal as well, try to make his escape, but he may not have enough. That's not going to connect either, but will he get away? The shockwave pulls in Kasing. Not enough damage to finish him off, but man, that was close.
Very, very close. Forced a lot of summoners. They tried to get two of the shockwave, but all they want here is still that tower. This was the roam down from the mid lane. Suddenly four guys shows up, and you have to leave. You cannot sit and defend 2v4, so this gives the bottom lane tower for SK. That's what they wanted mainly. Kills would have been a bonus, but they got the tower they won. Top lane, last one alive of the outer turret for H2K. While Odo Omnes has done a fine job in the laning phase, he's not going to do a whole lot to defend it if SK sends up Forgiven and Enraider to take it down. Dragon is also coming up soon. That could be the first focus before we go top lane for SK.
I could indeed. Dragon's a minute and a half on the clock. Odo Omnes is hell-bent on finishing off this tower if he can. See if he can make something happen before Svenskeren shows up. Looks like he's actually not going
to
show up.
So
yeah, this should be a tower taken by H2K. Odo Omnes not got teleport just yet, so he'll have to take the long route. Fortunately, he's got an express route.
This is good to get to the tower. Very important for H2K to start getting some gold. Ryu is running cooldown reduction per level blues. Very standard on Kassadin. What we have seen in China a lot is then you go Codex, and then you finish your Hourglass before you even get to the Athenes. It comes in as like the third item, but you just aim on getting almost max cooldown reduction or as much as possible early on, just to lower the cooldown on your ultis.
Yeah, Yharnam looking for Fox here. This could be a fight for H2K. Fox, not quite down. There he goes. The Lantern pulls Yharnam back, and Lulex tanking in the front. They pick off Fox just like that. SK dropped their guard. Ryu going to hop over the wall, try to avoid the Sonic Wave, and it comes around again. Svenskeren is going to have to get out of town, and he will. Ward hopping into the Dragon Pit. For the next 20 seconds, though, H2K have number advantage. Let's see if that changes. Lulex isolated. Yes, it does. The crucial smite is taken out. SK Gaming still in a very good spot here with the next Dragon on the horizon.
Svenskeren really want to win this series here. His Lee Sin once again has been so good, and the whole setup from SK in the early game has allowed him to play so aggressive around the pink wards in the jungle of H2K. Another Dragon being picked up. 16 minutes in, 2 for SK. Can they defend the mid tower? That's what H2K is trying to trade for. It's going to be very, very hard with a ping also here in the river, denying vision from the, so they can't really see how many guys are coming up towards
them. Yeah, but they didn't have enough damage on the tower either to really make a dent in it. So, two Dragons now for SK Gaming, still defend their mid tower. 3,000 gold in the lead. That's not too bad, DeFicio.
Not too bad at all. You open up the map. That's the important one. So you can keep pressuring down these lanes. Here's the move from Ryu in the bottom side. Just trying to soak up farm on the Kassadin, who is not been working well. It's gonna take a while. It's not been working well for them because SK could force so many fights around that mid lane. It is by no means over. but it's definitely in favor of SK with the way the early game has been going.
Well, H2K have played a little frantically, I would think, here, and it's not netted them too many results. One kill, no dragons, a couple of towers, sure, but you're falling behind to this SK squad that can and will punish you in the middle of the game. Let's see if Lulex gets out of this one. He should. He gives up the Skull Crab, just fine, not worth the life.
No, but this is all the setup for SK to start pushing top lane. You see how they get some wards in the jungle, they have even a pink in the river, they get the Rift Scuttler, so they can see everything going on the top side of the map now. And this opens up for Kim to start pushing it in. You mentioned how the Sion, while he's done a fantastic job in the laning phase, he's not going to do a whole lot to hold this one. He needs more members from H2K to defend it. They're trying to send up both jungle and support. Not really going to be there in time, already being forced away.
Yeah, SK should be able to take this one. Sven Skaren wants to take even more. Lulex is in some serious trouble. He goes down. Odawamne can't get the chop off. It was Lulex who was on the chopping block. SK keep on pushing for it. Eyeballing turret number two now at the top.
Sven just never stops.
There comes Odawamne. The Fountain Forgiven.
That's good.
They have
take him down. He's on the
tower. He's the Monsoon, though. And he's going to bail out Odawamne. Really wants to finish him up. The shields are on. The Shockwave going to connect. Odawamne is not going to live through this one. Just barely. Comes back to life. Zombie Odawamne as Yharnam has to get away from the tree. Let's see if he'll be able to do it with On the Hunt. Yes, he does. Trade one for one at the end of the day, but Forgiven taking him out of the picture means the tower will live for another day.
Love to engage here from H2K. Minions were dead, so they simply locked down Forgiven. I think he was tanking tower as well. Ends up getting a very important kill on the Kassadin. This is what they need. Ryu is the guy you need to invest your resources into. You want to try and win any team fights in the near future. So it's going to be tough. SK has a good lead on this one, or in this one. With all other turrets gone, we're going to have to see. Do you want to put the focus on the bottom side to secure that dragon and then swap it to Baron after? Because what you want to do now, typically, is you push in mid and you push in the top lane, you take over the jungle around the blue buff, and then you clear the wards on Baron. So you create that illusion that, hey, we can take Baron right now. Yes, it's early in the game, but we can be on it. And you have to walk into your own jungle with zero vision and potentially face checkers.
SK's done this before.
They've done this many
times. Series, especially.
We need to see Scrying Orb coming in for Yharnam very, very soon. Because he might be the only guy who can check if that Baron is being started or not.
Yeah, oh, Sven kicks Kasing back in. He will be using the flash to hop his way, and he gets Sven caught up on a line. Do they have enough damage to take him down? Not quite yet. Ryu goes forward on a Rift Walk. The Null Sphere won't be enough. Teleport in from Odawamne.
Forgiven!
He's taken down. Forget one prize. We'll take the other. And in comes the Sion. Stops just short. Can't quite pick up and rate it. They get something for that, though. Let's see if they can take a tower after the fact.
Yeah, Svensson's going back to base. Another good pickup here. For H2K, Freddy wasn't even near. He was walking from topside when Sven jumped in and tried to create that pick. He didn't respect the TP from Odawamne.
They
end up costing
him
more.
Freddy again. He's gonna twist his pants onto the menu. The chase is on as Lulex came around the side. Shockwave pulling in Ryu and Odawamne, but Fox is already down. The Monsoon pushes him right back out. Ryu still taking up everything. Freddy caught in the line. Yharnam popping the heal. Ryu is still gonna make it out. The tower, though, is still defended.
More kills for H2K, though. We'll also be able to just disengage away, not losing anyone. Didn't get the mid tower like they wanted. The two kills for Yharnam suddenly. The carries starting to get some gold for H2K. And still loads of time before any objective is alive. TP advantage for SK, so if they can make a play like this next time. This one here, backfired completely.
Yes, it did indeed. H2K get themselves a little bit something back here. Red buff spawns as Sven and Raider were thinking about going home, but they'll will be grabbing a bite to eat before they head back to the base. Kasing will show up just in time to realize it's happening. Oh, he hooks up the blue, or the red rather, but it's still taken by Sven.
He helped. What was going on? Showing I'm here.
Yeah.
Small ones wasn't cleared though. Not
what is going on, DeFicio?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I mean, SK Gaming has been playing a strong early game. Somewhat expected, I guess, if you look at how they wanted to punish the Kassadin for his passive early. Sven's gone on Lee Sin against the Cinderhulk jungler as well. And then they've just been getting a little bit too greedy, I think it's fair to say, the last few minutes. And that's what H2K has used to get some kills and keep the hope alive of a game 5.
Well, One thing they could do to keep the hope alive even more here is to contest this dragon. It's coming up in less than 30 seconds. Yeah, I agree. It's going
to
be really difficult. They've not got the vision. They've not got the members around here. And there's no teleport on Owamne, and there is one on Freddy. So everything is going SK's way for this next Drake.
You don't really want to walk straight into a 5-on-5 that has already been set up by SK Gaming. You want to keep trying to punish them if they're a little bit, if they're over aggressive when they go for picks. That's where you want to punish them and try and get back this way. They can maybe trade a mid tower for this dragon if they push it in very fast, but it's difficult because once again, there's no real wards in the river to spot SK coming in from the side, and they don't have time to do it either.
No, the quick dragons, it's SK's specialty, and they don't really manage to get much out of that at all. 3 dragons to none, now the scoreline. SK Gaming still in the lead by a few thousand gold over H2K, but they haven't looked flawless in the last few minutes.
It's really scary. When SK Gaming gets the first 3 dragons, they're 12-1. They've lost one game where they got all the early dragons. They need to keep applying pressure on H2K if they want another win in this one. Not that they have a bad early game by any means. The double Cinderhold tank, though, can just be so tough to grind your way through. And we know this casted in build, the unlimited mana casted in build, can really snowball out of control in fights late game.
All right, so they've caught Freddy. There's on the hunt pop. The tower's still protecting. Freddy will go with eventual Maelstrom. The box is down, and no one's checking into it just yet. And they push him back. For the time being, Sven's still looking to maybe take even more, as Fox wasn't even there, moves around the side. Suke still burns some crucial ultimates, and they don't get anything out of it, once again.
No, now SK sees an opportunity to group 5. You have Lucian Orianna. If you see Ryu on the bottom side, you can push it in. Or you can just move to the Baron here, try and clear out this few wards already being placed from H2K. Now again, you might create this situation where H2K has to come and face check you. They do have Scrying Orb on the Sivir, but it looks like SK is fine resetting the whole map, waiting for the minion waves to push in the side lanes and then push them back, especially in the bottom lane, before you start making any plays around that Baron. At least everyone is recalling.
Oh, Freddy, they're being gonna find Freddy.
That was a very risky place to recall.
Oh yeah. Oh, and he may not get a chance to after this one. Lulex Nodawamne just bashing away, trying to scratch the bark. Freddy, he's not gonna live through this one. No way does he get away.
Can
they
it
give
over
it over to
Yarnin
too? Nicely played by H2K.
And this again is just H2K punishing SK for losing focus. Honestly, you're recalling in the enemy jungle on your own. That didn't make any sense. And another kill for Yarnin. 18 seconds for Freddy. Does have TP ready. But H2K can be happy at least getting something in a situation where they weren't supposed to get anything.
Exactly. Now, there's a big wave building up on the top side. That's going to demand some attention from SK Gaming fairly soon.
That's what they were waiting for. They were waiting for these side lanes to push in, push them back, and then start making plays around the Baron?
One thing that is really troubling here for H2K, though, is that they've been very much unable to clear out a lot of the river vision that SK have established, partially because they've been punished for it so many times, and partially because they're just not able to move in there safely at all. So as a result, SK still maintained a fair amount of map control on the board here, but all the map control of the world isn't going to help you much when you try to back in the enemy jungle.
Nope.
When everyone else is around. I should clarify.
Agree on that one. Given going back a bit late, opens up this tower for H2K now.
Yep.
Take a 3-1 at least.
Been trying to take it down for a while. This time they're able
slowly
to take it.
Slowly but surely.
Free.
It's getting more and more. Everything SK offers, H2K takes it. It's okay. We're not out of this game yet. Yes, we're behind in terms of dragons, but we're getting stronger and stronger. We should be able to contest the 4th one, or at least the 5th one if you wait for items on the Cassidy. We do see the Rod of Ages into Hourglass with the Codex in between. From Ryu simply to try and make his make him a little bit stronger. His cooldown reduction is around like 25% at this point with CDR per level. So he's simply trying to get slow cooldown possible on his ulti, and he has a fight.
They're going to find Forgiven as they knock him back in. Yarnin taking that one. There was a teleport coming out as Freddy and Svenskeren are in the back, but there's not that much damage. The shockwave coming in. Freddy, now they're chasing out and raided in Fox. This is H2K's fight. They're going to take another. Fox is burning away, and he is gone. He's not going to go down, but Freddy certainly is, and it's 4 kills just like that. Fox still on the run. This could open up the Baron for H2K. They are, however, pinging out Fox right now. I think they'll just try to scare him up a little bit. Yeah. Baron not going to be contested at all. H2K take a brilliant fight, and they're not done yet. Fox, this could be the ace. They get it. They're going to get the Baron. Turning that right in their favor. And just like that, it's a gold lead.
Just another fantastic engage from Lulix. Body slam, flash in. Look at the engage here from the Gragas. Look at your minimap coming from the river. He's looking at Forgiven. He's gonna body slam flash into him and then knock him back into his own team. Kill him first. Now the fight is won because the main damage dealer is gone. And you can start cleaning up from H2K. You get the Baron. That engage was so good. And H2K are right back in this game. They have the goal lead and everything.
Oh yeah. Odoamne could be in a little bit of trouble here, but look at how much he's doing to them. And the rest of his team is behind him. Freddy now, he's the one who's isolated out, and he's gonna go down, chop down that tree. Odoamne. This game has gone completely 180. 30 seconds left on the Drake now, DeFicio.
Yeah, SK Gaming was so good in the early game. And then it was almost like he said, okay, no need to focus anymore. Randomly getting picked off, giving kills to H2K, and then it's just full credit to H2K in that last team fight with the engage from Lulix to win it. And SK Gaming, suddenly, very far behind. Also, if you look at the comps, the Cinderhulk is starting to scale up. The Kassadin is going to get his Athenes very, very soon. Rear is sitting. Well, not 600 gold, but he's going to get a tower, don't worry.
Yeah, they're going to get even more out of that one. So one tower.
They can even
burn
go take
the
dragon
shield
now and
yeah,
stop
no problem.
That fifth dragon thing.
No problem at all. Yeah, forget. Who cares about that fifth dragon thing, right? It's going to be H2K easily picking this one up. They have gone ahead so far. They've got scaling on their side. The Kassadin will start to roll out of control. Yharnam's just been sitting on a mountain of gold after the kills that they've been able to pick up. So dragon number one to them. And importantly, they had done all that before without that first dragon buff, without that AD and AP.
Really well played by H2K in this game here.
What else can they take?
Ryu only had like 800 gold when he went back, so he just like, whatever, I get a blasting wand, I get something.
No problem. Well, he could be getting up to a void staff pretty soon if he wants.
He can for sure.
Or a death cap. Yeah, SK Gaming, after controlling the game so well, they make a couple of crucial mistakes, but that fight was absolutely massive for H2K. All credit to Lulex for setting it up, but the rest of the team followed through incredibly well. And since then, it just has looks like a completely different matchup.
They have a very good late game comp. Sven is trying to start something.
Yeah, but they picked Lulex, and let's see if they can take him down. Sven is the one who's taking a whole lot of damage. The barrel comes out, and Odoamne is still in the fray. The hook on to Sven Skaren, as in comes Kasing. The box should go down. The monsoon, it doesn't even mean a thing. There's a big shockwave, but it comes way too late as H2K get three kills more on the board.
Yeah, now you're trying to engage onto Lulex. He's fine. You might have been able to bully him a little bit in the early game. Now he's a big tank up in the front here, and H2K suddenly looking to close out the game in their favor. It looked so bad if we go 10 minutes back.
But this isn't 10 minutes ago, DeFicio. Oh, Ryu, he's going for Fox right now. He might have gone too far forward. Pops his Zhonya's Hourglass, and he's got enough to take down Fox anyways in the kamikaze. But meanwhile, Yharnam's back in the mid, and that's going to be an inhibitor taken out. So how about that? Just about worth. Oh, maybe even more.
Another guy we got to highlight here. H2K managed to get so many of the early kills onto Yharnam, so he got an item advantage over Forgiven, which also, of course, been a big factor in the comeback from H2K, but it's all gone so fast. A few picks, then a big team fight, then a Baron, and this one here, well, that's now we get to see H2K, what happens if you cannot get onto any of the carries. You've already been chunked down because you've only been hitting one of the tanks. Yharnam's just standing there, spamming auto attacks away, and then Kassadin comes in.
And yeah, this fight's over. That's a great shockwave. You needed it about 5 seconds before, at least.
I think he was really able to pull it, though.
Yeah, I mean, there was
H2K
no...
didn't have to chase
him on anything. They split quite well. It just comes down to, I think, the desperation from SK Gaming. They're seeing their window of opportunity close. They're seeing H2K scale up, and they've just made simply too many mistakes now. And now that H2K has started this snowball, it's starting to roll downhill pretty quickly.
Yeah. I mean, I would love to see the gold, the swing in the last minutes, because they were down.
That's the hill it's rolling down, DeFicio.
Completely.
It's definitely a quick change of pace. And now, so we're 32 minutes into this game. We'll take a quick breather on that one because it's a 6,000 gold advantage over at HK plus a little bit of change. They got themselves a dragon in all of that. They'd had the Baron, of course, for a while. They made it work. Next one's 2 minutes away. But you can just tell, looking at the way that they're fighting, the way that they're playing, SK Gaming don't seem to have an answer at all.
No, because they've been stuck in these fights now where they no longer have that lead. And there's no real target for them to kill. I mean, the dive potential they do have is the Maokai going in with their with the Bolon from Orianna as a shockwave, but you got Spell Shield from Sivir to block the Maokai engage. You will have Flash Up as well for him. You got the Gragas who can always disengage with his ulti, and then you got the two big tanks in the front as well. Also the Gragas and of course the Sion. So H2K is just running out of targets for themselves, and they simply cannot match the damage coming in and the tankiness coming in from H2K. We're gonna have to see a fantastic shockwave being pulled if SK is to turn this one around.
Yeah, they desperately need Fox to be able to make that one happen. They need the perfect angle of engage, but they've got to fight a war on two fronts here as Odawamne pushes in some super minions. In the middle, they're not going back to defend it just yet. In another wave, they're gonna catch Svenskeren though. Do they go all the way into this one? It looks like they might. Monsoon, he's gonna stay alive. Some safeguard helping him out too, but Harnen all of a sudden is on the hunt. They look for the tower. Now they might turn their attention to Freddy. There's the ball, but it only connects on Ryu and Lulex, and he's going to pop his Zhonya's. The tower still taking a whole heaping helping of damage as Kasing flays the members of SK Gaming back. The explosive cast comes in. Freddy comes in onto Odawamne. He's gonna flash away, and Raiden got it alive. The damage, it's just too much as Yharnam picks up a godlike kill. Freddy now on the retreat. Ryu somehow still staying alive. Spencer Depp, a double kill. They'll get even more. How about a triple? And we're going for inhibitors again.
And we're going for game five, Pyro. H2K should be able to finish this one. What a comeback from them. They punish SK Gaming for losing the focus.
It just goes to show you cannot get complacent. H2K will turn it around on you time and time again. They're on the Nexus turrets. H2K want this, the difference in championship points, the glory in their first split of making the top three of the LCS in Europe. They're not gonna end it though, DeFicio. The death timers are too low still.
All right, we're still, 34 minutes in. Maybe we're a little bit too early on that one.
Yeah, but it started to look like it for a second.
Oh yeah, and H2K, it's of course their game to lose.
There's a teleport in from Freddy here.
SK trying to rush a Baron now.
This is a desperation move, but if it works out, it could buy them some serious time.
Odawamne has TP, so he can come back from base. Ryu is there already on the Kassadin. Smacking that Sion into the enemy's face.
I mean, it's at half its health already. SK, if one thing they're good at, they're able to take objectives quickly. But will they have the chance? It's gonna get secured. Ryu's in the middle. Can he make his escape? Can SK take this fight? They've got the Baron on. What can they do? Svenskeren finding Yharnam and Ryu around the backside. He's gonna pick off Kasing. That means Ryu is still hanging around, and Raiden goes down just like that. A triple kill, and they're going for even more. Oh my goodness, a double for Sven, but it won't be enough. That is gonna be the wipe, and that has gotta be the game.
Yeah, they got super minions coming into the base here. 30 seconds on most of the members. You might get a Baron, but H2K, they get an ace for themselves. 11-0 Yharnam, the guy who got all the early kills.
11-0-9.
And what a game from him.
Yeah, what a game indeed. He's not a hyper carry, but he's certainly starting to play like one. They charge headfirst into the Nexus turrets. The Nexus is going down. We're going to game number five. H2K have brought it back.
And SK Gaming cannot be happy after that mid game. Such a good start. Svenskeren on Lee Sin was everywhere, just killing people left and right. You got the towers, you had 3 or 4k goal lead. You were looking to start baiting a Baron, and then you just get caught off guard one by one from recalling in the enemy jungle.
And then the fight.
And then the fight, set up by Ludix. We were talking about how first picking that Gragas could be risky when Janna was open, he could go for Sejuani. But the way he pulled off that play, knocking Forgiven back, giving them an ace and a Baron, big, big turning point for H2K. They were like 2 or 3 gold ahead after that play, after the Baron.
We
and
said
suddenly
this.
They just snowballed out.
We said this in Champ Select, why the Gragas, the Sejuani worked out so well for them in the previous game. That was why he was able to do so much, not just in that fight, but even when they caught him out, he was able to put a huge amount of distance between the team. The disengage was far too good. And, you know, you could argue that Janna might be able to help with the same thing, but you saw how quick N-Rated got chunked down.
Every time.
every single time. And that Cinder Hulk, incredibly what? Useful.
I don't think it's about Gragas Sejuani anymore. I think Lulex is just so good at starting these fights. So he acts as the main engage, and that's working for H2K when it comes to picking the right ones. Mm-hmm. The way he can single out a target in the backline, forgiven twice now, two games in a row, forgiven on Lucian, is being shut down. Every time we have a big team fight,
they're not afraid of this.
Don't care. They dive onto him, they kill him instantly. They cast it in while it didn't look great in the start. Lost so much early pressure from H2K. Once you started snowballing, and get the kills.
Both, I suppose, at this point.
I guess you just. Yeah.
It was nuts. It was absolutely
nuts. What a turnaround.
That's what we have to say. I'm sure you guys want to know what our analyst has to say. We're going to send it back over to them to break down the madness.